Hey everybody, can you see me now? Says I'm live. I had to go to my iPad. Something's wrong with my computer. Can somebody send me a message and let me know that they actually can hear me? Hey Canada, hey Taylor Marie. I really apologize for this. I hate to say it, but I've never done a Facebook Live before. And I tried doing it on my desktop computer and it kept telling me that my camera wasn't supported. And anyway, I'm just gonna do this through my iPad. My name is Frank Myers, and I want to welcome everybody to a Rising Star Road Trip. And I'd like to thank Cameron Wallace Tilbury, a.k.a. Camo, for inviting me to take over his Facebook page. Let me try to move this. Okay. Sorry. Okay. Golly, I got a new microphone and everything for this, and let me turn those lights down. I can see them blasting back there. Oh, I guess it must be coming through the windows over here. All right. Sorry, everybody. I came to Nashville in 1981 and started working with a guy named Eddy Raven, and I was very blessed when I came to town, having some big hit records, and I want to play some of those hits for you today, and I also have a new single coming out I want to share with you later, but I'm going to play some of these. This first song I wrote for my wife, Belinda. And it was actually my second cut and my first single. And it goes like this. It was recorded by Eddy Rabbit and Crystal Gale. So I'm going to kind of do an abbreviated version of this for you. Since Crystal isn't here to sing it with me. So hope you enjoy. Just you. Sharing our love together, and I know in time we'll build the dreams we treasure, and we'll be all right. Just you. Just you and I. First single. I was so blessed. It went number one on the country charts and was top five AC and pop. And thank you again for joining me here on this today. Again, I sure apologize for the beginning. I'm just going to have to check out and see what's going on with the camera on my desktop computer. But I just wanted to share a few stories and some songs before I play you my single that's coming out. It's called God's Got This, but I'm going to play that for you a little bit later. As I told you, I moved to Nashville, and I started playing lead guitar for Eddy Raven, and I worked with Eddie for 9 years. Co-wrote a bunch of his songs and went around the world with him, and actually ended up working with Marie Osmond, too, for 4 years, and was in a duo called Baker and Myers. But this was Eddy Raven's first number one song as an artist. Now, we've done that song a few hundred times, traveling around. I want to say hello to everybody over in the UK and Canada and all my Facebook friends that I have on Facebook at Frank Myers Music. y'all hit me up. I'd love to get some new friends on there. Check out my website, www.frankmyersmusic.com. And here's a song right now that was a number one record for the band Alabama. And we toured a lot with Alabama. Great guys, Teddy and everybody. Had a whole lot of fun back then doing the June Jam and a bunch of live concerts. It wasn't anybody bigger back then. This is called Once Upon a Lifetime. I wrote this with my buddy Gary Baker. Has any questions, we'd be more than happy to answer them for you. Hello to the person that just went by and from Norway and UK and Canada, and I saw a couple people I know saying hello. Thank you so much for being here with me. I guess the next song I'm going to do is, first of all, I'm going to take a sip of water. Excuse me. Have it right here. Cheers. This song is a song that I wrote with Richie McDonald of Lonestar and my buddy, the great Don Frimmer, who passed away a few years ago. God rest his soul. Don was a mentor to me. He was a great lyricist. Couldn't carry a tune in a bucket or play an instrument, but he was a great lyricist and really helped me become a better lyricist. And so we went out to Richie's house to write, and supposedly the horses got out and they had to fix the fence or something. But anyway, we got out there and there wasn't even a fence up. They were actually putting a fence up, so he was just really trying to blow us off that day. But anyway, we were up on this big wraparound front porch, and we were looking at this beautiful view, and the kids were playing inside this big picture window, and Don was looking at them laughing, and Richie and I are looking out at the big view. And I kept saying, there's a great idea off this front porch. This view is just awesome. But Don said, it isn't as good as the view looking in. And when he said that, we all looked at each other, and there you go. We have us a song idea. So this was a big number one record for Lonestar. Hope you enjoy it. Jack Daniels in a spray bottle right here. Anyway, thank you for all the great comments from London, England, and Norway, Canada, all over the place. I appreciate it. I'd love to come over to the UK and do a show over there. That'd be awesome. Well, this song right here is another song that I wrote with Richie McDonald and my buddy Gary Baker. And we'd all come off the road. It was a Monday. And Richie and I had met over at one of the performing rights buildings, and we were having coffee, waiting on Gary to show up. We were tossing ideas around, and nothing was hitting me, nothing was hitting him. And just all of a sudden, he went over to the keyboard and started playing, "Hello from Germany, good to see you," or "Good to see you, thank you for checking in." So he goes to the keyboard and he starts to play this song, and I said, "Well, what's that?" And he says, "Well, I was out on the road, and I called home, talked to Lori and the kids, and I got a little homesick, so I started this." And I said, "Well, man, I love what you got started there. Let's write that. Hello, Argentina." So we ended up writing it. Gary showed up, and we finished the song. It became a 7-week number one song for Lone Star. And then the coolest thing happened. The military adopted the song and gave it a whole new life. When you're on the road all the time, you know, this real stuff like this really hits home. So, and we were all on the road a lot back then.
And the whisper in the wind, and I'll be
Nice texts. Appreciate that. I would like to give a big shout out to Kat and Emma and Brooke at Music City Media. They did a great job putting together my new website, www.frankmyersmusic.com. And they've been keeping me busy and making sure social media knows what's going on. And I just want to say thanks again, ladies, for all your hard work. I appreciate you. I apologize for my computer melting down at the beginning of this. So I wrote a song that Travis Tritt and John Mellencamp cut. I'm going to do for you. I thought that was pretty cool. John Mellencamp being such a great songwriter. Maybe you remember this. It's called What Say You? To do now my song that I have coming out. It comes out on August 28th, and we have a pre-sale, pre-save event happening on the 14th, and the video for the song comes out as well on the 14th. And this song is for all of us who are scared, stressed out, and worried over the situation we are all in at the moment with COVID-19. And for all the other things that we are faced with that's out of our control in our lives. The song is about putting our faith, hope, and trust in God's plan and in God's hands. The song is called God's Got This. I can hear it in your voice, I can see it in your eyes. It's tearing at your heart, what's weighing on your mind? I know the road you're on, 'cause I've been in your shoes. But there's only one that's strong enough to carry you. God's got this, it's in His hands. So let go of all the things that you can't understand. He knows your fears, He hears your prayers. And when you're on your knees, you're not alone, He's always there. People that might need to hear that message right now, and I hope you grab a copy when it comes out, and if you know someone going through some tough times, send it to them. I appreciated it. You can go to my website, frankmyersmusic.com, and you can get it there, and everywhere digital music is downloaded and sold. Again, it's coming out on August 28th, and our pre-sale event is August 14th. So I'm going to do one more song, and I'm going to get out of here. And again, thank you so much for having me today. I apologize for the beginning, and but I'll try to get my my desktop computer remedied so that don't ever happen again. So this last song I'm going to leave you with is the biggest song of my career. It took 2 demos and 5 years, and I had to pitch it to John Michael Montgomery 3 times. before he finally cut it. But he did. And it was a 4-week number one song for him, and it was an 11-week number one pop song for All For One. Then the coolest thing happened, it started getting put in movies and all this kind of stuff. And you know you really got a good song when the Minions sing your song on Despicable Me 2. I thought that's pretty cool, and so did Gary's grandkids. So thank you so much again for tuning in and joining me today. God bless all of you. Thank you all so much for joining me. See you next time.